You locked your keys in the Jeep?
I think so. But Nikki's coming. She has a key anyways. Yeah, I don't see the back door. Yeah, I don't know where I would have put them. Hey.
Oh,
you're good? Yeah, I got two blocks. I think there's a third one, too.
Really?
No idea.
I, where could they be, though? Like, we've been here the whole time.
Weird,
super weird. I know, it must be, like, under something. I would have heard them fall on our walk in.
one's for you.
Hell yeah. No problem.
I don't have that exact one, I only had these. Nicest dudes, and they're the ones that gave me the heads up about the upcoming walls that we're invited to also.
Found him.
Oh!
Yay, we win. Or he likes it. These kids can still get out in this neighborhood where I am. They fucking like fill the skate parks with garbage. They cut them all, they shut them all down, they put plywood on the basketball hoop. I can't be on camera very. I went live in Vancouver for 4.5 hours on this, just talking to all the people, answering questions. But if I reverse it and put my on me, I freeze up. It's so weird. Same camera, same thing.
I watch a few of your videos every now and then. I think I skipped through that 4 hour live. Is that when you were at the yard?
Yeah, Columbia and Hastings one.
Oh, yeah, that one. Where
yeah.
You guys were on the booth.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm so glad I didn't have to go up. I'm so scared of that shit. I was, dude, because it was swaying, it was windy, and it was swaying, and I'm trying to film so I can't hold on to anything. Oh, man.
So many rats and, like, so many junkies. I just sat on top of this
tree. I was like, well, yeah, if you have all your baggage with you and you don't need to stop for anything, hell yeah. Yeah, like Craver, I'll definitely fucking buy those saddlebags off your red ones. Dude, it'd be so awesome for us because we can travel a lot farther then. Sick. Do you need more black? Still young. My grandma's 95 years old, lives in a giant mansion in Wally, and parties every day. She drives, has a car,
and it was a
crazy sports car with rims on it. Yep. Drives, wears full red leather Gucci suits. It's a weird world when your 95 year old grandma's dating your friend's dad.
Kind of cool.
You got to find a bunch of cool spots.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I knew most spots out there because of the miles and filming. Like, Fest is the furthest this way and Miles is the furthest that way. Yeah. And everything in between.
I
thought
we did before we went out.
Yeah, you guys went full reno with your dad and
did everything. Oh, we did. I resealed the whole roof. We were pretty stuck.
Did you have a lot of mechanical problems with the engine over time? It was pretty solid.
I have an old Dodge 440, man.
That's what I got. Oh, right? Shit.
Oh, fuck this. Yeah, the old Dodge 440 just fucking fired right up.
Yeah. Started in the morning, that's not good. Yeah. They're all good. Oh, yeah. Another edible.
Fucking COVID, maybe?
Yeah,
right.
Not fucking edible good.
Yeah.
Well, that's funny you've actually lived in one of those things. I was looking at buying one of those.
It was an old fucker.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mine was
78.
Holy shit.
Michael
was 82.
Damn,
I was
born by birth.
Yeah, I was 79. Yeah, shit. Wow.
No, they're cool, like, but that sounds like a cool setup that you guys got.
Yeah.
It's fun because we can go everywhere that pretty much Jeeps can go. So it doesn't even matter where motorhomes can go. We can go where Jeeps go. So we go in trails that are so tight. I'm like, this can't be happening. We can't do this. And we make it. We just throw it in four-wheel drive low. Just take your time. And, you know, we took that thing to Redstone. Now, Redstone is in between Williams Lake and Bella Coola. So it was about 700, 800 kilometers. And we're in a lifted Jeep. It was so bad on fuel, but it was so funny. It was just so fun. We hit a big bump on the Coca-Cola once. I looked in the mirror and the trailer was gone. I'm like, what the fuck?
Whoa.
I look in this mirror, I see the side of the trailer. What happened? Hit a huge bump and just bounced. It was connected.
Yeah, hell yeah. It was just like,
instead of that. And then it bounced this way, and then it bounced like 4 feet in the air. And it came bing, 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 bing.
Wow.
And it was fine. So I'm like, this thing go through hell.
Yeah,
like,
and your vehicle stuck.
I didn't do nothing. I thought it fell off. It was so weird. Because Jeeps, you're not supposed to tow with them because they're so small wheelbase. So the maximum you can tow safely is 3,000 pounds. But when I was looking at all those pop-up tents, they start at like 3,000 and go up, and that's empty. So I'm like, fuck, what are we going to do? So I looked at these cargo trailers, empty, they're 900 pounds. I was like, yes! I was like, shit, we can pull something. Because we were tired of tenting because we had some scary events tenting.
No more tenting.
We were in Grizzly Bear. Yeah. I'm not so worried about the black bears, but we were in Grizzly Bear country.
Oh
and
my gosh.
We were in Lion country a couple times. Well, lions everywhere. But
I was cooking fish for dinner and accidentally knocked the pan over
all
over our tent.
They smelled that from a mile.
Right? We were in Boston Bar, but we were 55 kilometers into the forest. So there's nobody around.
I poured fish sauce on everything.
Did you have a shotgun when you were?
Yeah, we both slept with rifles, but we were still scared. Because when we were going to bed, she slipped and poured the pan fish juice all over the tent instead of in the river. So we were covered in fish juice.
Dude,
we were
really
so scared.
Bad move.
All night long, we were like, fuck. We had loaded rifles. She had one eye, and we were just laying there with our hand over. Nope.
No. I don't know how.
I don't know. I just didn't slept in the front seat of my car.
Well, see, we had no roof on the Jeep.
So we're because we're in tiny Jeeps, right? So and I'm 6'6", there's no way I can sleep in them. So
then
we're getting a trailer. Now we sleep in them and feel good, right? Those things are designed to keep crackheads out for tools and theft and whatnot.
Right.
So
yeah,
it's all good.
Yeah, I guess that's why there's no point putting a window in.
Do we have windows?
There's windows.
See, when I got it custom made, I got them to put in an RV door, like a door with a handle,
just
opens, and it has windows, and we roll them up in the screens, just like a house. And then I got them to put a window on that side too, that's like this big. So we have two windows, a door, and then I got the drawbridge type opening, instead of the barn doors.
Yeah.
So we could just open up our thing and put a bucket under it, and now we have a little patio.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's
to lift the thing up so it's not down on the ground.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So and then if we ever want to use it in the future for a quad, we can just take the bed out and roll the quad up around it in it and we'll be good to go. But right now it's just our little mini house. It's way too small. Way too small.
Yes.
But when you're in the middle of nowhere and you're tired and you just pull over and your bed's made, it's like no tent, no pegs, nothing.
So who did you get to customize?
It's called Cummings in Abbotsford on Fraser Highway, like Cummings, and it's a trailer place. It's been there forever. And
is that the one right?
It's by Lake. Yeah, it's right on the number one near Mount Lehman.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. I just went in there. I told them what I wanted to do. They sketched it up for me and gave me a price. I was like, after taxes, that's it.
Holy shit!
So they custom made it all for me. And then what else did I get them to do? Oh, yeah, I got a 4-inch lift in it. So. Jeep has a 4-inch lift, the trailer has a 4-inch lift, so it matches. It's all even, all the way along.
Cool.
Yeah, it's pretty dope.
He really thought it was.
And that was like $3,500.
$3,800 before tax.
Wow.
So it was all in, it was well below $5,000. Well below. And then I insured it and it blew my mind. It was $90 a year. I was like, what?
It's well worth it.
And that includes full replacement insurance if it's stolen.
Oh, yeah. That's what was cool about. Put it in the RV, it's like you paid for the insurance on the thing, and that was technically your rent.
How much was yours?
Yeah.
I think it was like $180.
Yeah, so compared to rent, which is like $2,500 where I live.
Yeah.
But then I was getting rent from my apartment.
Yeah.
So that's why I was able to.
You were paying for it.
Yeah.
It's a good idea.
Yeah. And you still have it, so you can still, does it run?
It runs fine, but it's like, it should be parked in my folks' place.
Yeah, that's never good for those old fuckers.
No, so that's what I was saying. Like, I'd rather just gut it and redo it or something.
Dude, oh, there you go. Do it. Yeah, I am not a carpenter, so I learned how to, like, I used my first saw. I was like, what am I doing? Like, cutting, because the sheet of plywood was wider than the trailer, and I had to cut it, and I was like, whoa, man.
Yeah.
But I actually, like, fucking learned a lot doing it, so it's cool.
That's cool about those, like, mini boats that people find. It's like, they don't do any of this work like that, but then they start taking this project out, and they fucking love it.
And they learn a lot, right? Like, I'm no carpenter by any means, but I learned how to do a lot of shit, like measuring angles and shit.
Yeah.
Worked out. Like, we went to the Merritt Music Festival a couple years ago, and people were like, what do you guys have?
They thought
there?
We had a pony. They thought we were bringing, like, ponies.
A little tiny trailer.
A little tiny horse trailer.
A 6'6" dude sitting on a mini horse?
Right? I mean, what do you think I'm doing up here? I'm bringing a mini horse. Bad enough, I'm living in a mini house. People don't think I can fit in there, but honestly, I have a 7-foot bed, and I'm 6'6". I'd love to.
Yeah. Like, cut it so my side's, like, short.
Yeah, I cut the plywood because we wanted to have more room up near the door. So because my bed...
your sleeping area is,
yeah, like,
the plywood goes like this. The plywood goes like this.
They like to get out. I had my first...
This guy's a good guy. Laser beam sharp. Fastest hands in the West over here. Yeah. That's the only people I really felt bad for in this whole thing. Even though people lose their jobs and shit, I feel bad for the kids. They're stuck at home all summer with mom and dad.
Yeah.
Oh, the worst. Oh yeah, if you're only child too.
I have three brothers, so that would have been great for me.
Yeah, you guys would have been fine, but imagine, I didn't even think of the only child. That would be sad. Yeah, perks of when things are going good. When they're not going good, oh fuck. That's it. Are you back at 100 now? Do you feel 100% back? Look, it looks like it.
Yeah, like, I've been enjoying, you know, getting back into letter structure again, but, like, I keep trying different, like, I like some aspects of the, like, Vancouver hip crumbs type, like, that's why I wanted to try and do these highlight, low-light type things, but I've never done it before.
Oh, yeah, you know what? I've never seen you do low-lights. I've seen you do highlights lots.
But I'm not 100% sure exactly if I gotta keep working at it, but...
You look at it on camera, it makes sense.
Yeah, it's looking okay.
Oh, dude. The camera just translates everything. Yeah, I tore my meniscus getting off a chairlift in a snowboard. Yeah.
Hey, Phil, when will this video be out?
Probably 2 days.
Nice.
Just gotta find a song. And it doesn't matter what genre. Anything. I can seriously use any song on earth. Fruit bitter. Then I'll be the filming master. Just rolling down a hill.
We used to use Cobra in Montana and Spanish Montana in Belton. And I don't know, everybody seems to agree that this is their favorite paint. People tell me it doesn't last on freight trains, but all miles is a rolling for years and they seem fun.
Yeah, you guys flew through this today. I feel much better today just doing this. It's a lot of fat. Right? I hate being stuck at home. Hey, thanks, man. It And some days I'm like, what am I doing with my fucking health here? But so, you know what? Like, I wouldn't rather do anything else.
No.
Yeah, this is just my thing. We've been out filming some yards now, and we'll run into the next generation of kids. It's so weird because I can see myself in them.
Right.
Thanks, man.
Man, I got some, I think it was last week, ended up out and about with Johnny on bikes. We had a couple of cans on us and got some pretty hot spots downtown.
Really?
Yeah, full like flared out keg.
Oh!
It's crazy down there right now.
It's so different.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, I wonder what's going on with Lesson right now.
Yeah, so who, is he by himself?
Or him and Combo.
Oh, that's so funny, dude.
I know, isn't that funny? Because when we come out here, it's with Combo.
We were talking about possibly painting today.
Really?
And then, yeah, but I'm glad that him and Combo hooked up this week.
Yeah. No, it's funny, though, that we're out here, and normally when I'm out here, Combo's out here. Well, we are getting mudded out here. Skate park of graffiti.
Yeah. So silly.
I know. Yeah. They're so cute. They're
so cute. Hey guys, what are you talking about? Don't worry, I'll send you my flick. It's so funny though. Just in the bush. And switch to 4K for the final screenshot so that it'll come up.